We've built up a supply of, what are they called again? Bus. So we might as well start upgrading parts of this building over here. Let's see. We can get bonus stress recovery at the transept, which seems handy. Make it more handy. The next rank reduces treatment cost. That's rough. There's so many ranks to go in here where it goes bonus slot and then increased strength, stress recovery and then reduced cost one by one. Let's get a second cloister rank because that's usually one of the cheaper ones. Robe,
claiming communion with the divine. Madness.
Once I get all these stress recovery buildings maxed out, we'll be in a good state. Let's see, I think I'm just going to bring the same crew in again, honestly. Let's just double check their weapons and stuff to see if they're upgraded. I think that crew, I think, went really well. Part of it wasn't super optimized for the boss fight, but all of them are still healthy at the moment, so I figure I might as well go in there again, although Vice will then max themselves out. I'm going to go for the wield, because out of the medium tier options I see here, that's the one that gives me more deeds. Big ol' stack of six. So we're gonna look for six. We're gonna look for three infected corpses. If I can find six deeds, that'd be great. We'd be about halfway to my goal. I'm hoping we'll find more along the way. Hopefully. So we have these three salves to put on the corpses, so we're gonna want to keep an eye out for there. It's a medium run. Right? Yes, medium. Right, I knew that because I should have known that based on the firewood was the thing to check there. So usual approach is two stacks of torches. Let's see. I can probably get away with less food than I usually bring, just enough to go hungry a few times, because we have strong recovery in the party this time around. So I can probably get away with a little bit less than I usually like to bring. There we go. Let's see if we can minimize the amount of dying we do today. That'd be my ideal situation. Alright. Oh no. Fuck you. I'm not starting this mission with a shambler. Probably just avoid the shambler altogether. Alright, that's corpse. We can do herbs on that. There we go. Among other things, it's just a chance to free that inventory slot, because we already have limited slots to begin with, and the quest objective just made that more restrictive than ever. Howdy, folks. Right, I don't like these guys very much. So everything involving spores can be a bastard because it likes to rearrange the party. So the big target that I don't like is confusion spores up front here. So if I could stun him, that'd be fantastic. So I'm gonna go for that. There we go, we still got it. We had like a 65% chance of success, I want to say. 69% chance of success, because he has a 70% resistance. That's a nice little head start there. Alright, I could go for damage, which isn't super high, but it's measurable at least. Given these options, I think I would start with the battery. Especially since more people can target that particular enemy. Hey now. We're in a particular setup where you're in the wrong spot. Right, because that attack moved me to the forward. That part was kind of a mistake, I guess. But the high chance of stunning was kind of worth it to minimize how many turns that bastard gets. Because of how big that guy is, we'll be able to bleed both of them at once, which will be nice. At the moment, though, I just want to go in for hits. He's kind of stuck on the front row. Alright. Let's spread the damage about. Let him bleed. Three per round, that's nine bleed, and there's a decent chance we'll last three more rounds, so that's a lot of damage incoming. Let's go for the retribution. Yeah. We'll set up a defense next. Let's see, his stun resistance is very high now, 110%. I'd have a 19% chance of success, so we're not going to try that right now. Said we're stacking attacks on the battery to increase the chance of him dying. Unfortunately, he'll survive by one hit point, but I can compensate a bit. As the fiend falls, we could just not wait for the bleed. This guy's taking six damage per round from the bleed, and he's already down to 60. So he's softened up. There we go. It's probably... But the basic math is that it is probably better to not rearrange my melee characters, but I think it's counterproductive to spend a turn rearranging him now to go back, is what I would say. Normally I'd be doing de-stressing stuff right now to try to push it back a bit, but more than anything, I don't want this guy to get a nice confusion spore off and really mess with my party composition in a way that I don't want them to be. Oh, the stun was resisted that time. Not quite as successful. No one's really hurt, so we'll just keep hitting them. Even the Vestal gets a turn. How fantastic. 20 damage. He's down to... Oh, he's dead now. There we go. Now I can do stress recovery while we well on this crone, which admittedly might die before we do any actual stress recovery. Yeah, it'll be worth doing a little bit of it, though. Ooh, a dodge. Alright, let's go ahead and heal up. We'll be doing more of that in future fights, but specifically when I'm fighting confusion spores, I don't want to deal with this so much. Let's just wail on her. I don't want to delay a turn, because if we hang out and try not to hit her for a whole turn, we'll start having panic problems, because the game is balanced to try to stop you from doing exactly that. There we go. Party's rearranged. This is one of the corpses. And now it's been cleansed. And we got three deeds, which is one of my goals, so I'm very happy to see that, for sure. I don't know why I'm rearranging my inventory like it matters. Come on, secret room. Nope. Treasure room, though. I'll check it out. I'll be your Huckleberry. We're about to run into an ambush, so pop that torch real quick. Howdy, folks. Yeah, here's where I'll use my stress recovery. Because there's no spore people in the party. Everyone who can is going to want to target the Enchantress in the back, because she has a lot of stress spamming abilities. Next target should be the Vestal. Alright. Let's put a hole in her real quick.
First blood.
Oh. Ah, dodged. Yeah, that riposte is pretty perfect too. Oh, there's that dodge again though. Not quite working out for me. And this character can't target them, so let's kill a dog. Destroyed. Not something I thought I'd say today. Dogs don't leave corpses behind for some reason. Maybe the artist just didn't want to make a dead dog. Although this is like halfway there already. Alright, she got the stress off. Oh, come on, man. Alright, fine. Probably gonna want to actually heal soon. Do I have bandages? Just holy water. Keep wailing on him. We'll do mace bash. There we go. No more incoming stress. So at least that bit'll stop. You about to get smacked? Bye. It was nice knowing you. Wow, that was a lot of gold for a dog fight. Don't take that out of context. No ego, why? Not get your ego out of here. Stop it. Ooh. Aw. Still better than like diseases or something. Oh, that's the thing I don't like to see. Hi, thing I don't like to see. Few things going on here, but more than anything, I just want to get it before it does confusion spores. Because that is an awful attack. Alright, party is still doing pretty healthy. Going for the dazzling light. No, not quite. Alright. Let's see, the bleed is 4 versus 3. Oh, he's in both the middle slots, so there's no reason to do the AoE, because it'd be hitting him twice anyway, which it can't do. So we'll damage him down as best I can. You're next up for stuns, but you do the highest damage, so I probably don't want to waste that. So we'll try to leave it to this guy. Ah, but Rampart does involve moving fine. There we go. I just really don't want him to do that move. Thankfully, he's nice and slow. I've just been burned so many times by a party being rearranged at the wrong time that I just actively try to avoid that now. I probably should have used the stun with the Crusader, because rearranging the party is probably a bad idea, and I keep making that mistake. Alright, that was one turn of stun. We can't really get away with that twice in a row. We might be able to damage him down fast enough. Up, here it comes. Oh no! He got it off anyway. That's pretty bad. Don't like that. But he's almost dead, and he's the biggest damage dealer, so if he dies of bleed, which he will, then even if we have a rearranged party, that rearranged party just has to fight a dog and a crone. Worst things have happened. Let's work on that stress. There we go. She was getting a little high there. And thankfully, yeah, he can melee from back there. We're definitely gonna have to heal soon. He dies from bleed, so no need to worry about that. And I can rearrange the party if I use a rampart. Yeah, that more or less fixed it, honestly. That could have gone way worse. Let's heal him up before it gets worse. He's got that nice bonus modifier that we should take advantage of, because she's still using the healing item. And let's stop the stress. Well, close to down. Stop it. Oh. Ah, well. We'll have to work on that. Alright, set up retribution again. Because it's down. Come on, get it, puppy. There we go. He's just about as good as new. Oop. And so is that dog, unfortunately. Wasn't exactly my plan. Well, I'm getting extra heals off at least, because the dog's missing. And really no one's doing very well right now. More loot playing. Yeah, the dog dodging, but then also missing just kind of gave me a free extra turn of recovery. Oh, apparently this trend will continue. Fine. I'll take it. Oh, there, never mind. Wow, that hurt. Wow, three more deeds. Foolish horrors. Fantastic. Brought low and driven into the mud. We're already looking at 12 deeds for one run now. Gold, trinkets and baubles, paid for in blood. Given the options, what would I want to sacrifice here? Probably the holy water, honestly. For some good old onyx. But yeah, we're gonna want to find our objective soon. We need to get rid of these objective items that are filling up my inventory, and hopefully find our way to, I probably want to make it a little further before I try resting. But we'll want to rest too, though. To get rid of the firewood. But for the full benefit, I want to be a little bit more hurt, maybe, before I do it. Hunger is happening. Alright. Quick healing opportunity, I guess. This room's empty, but whatever comes after it might not be.
The way is lit.
Ooh, scouting.
The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow.
So we're walking directly into a fight. Howdy, maggots! This sounds like a nice opportunity for an easy heal. Probably want to do retribution. Less damage, but they're fairly likely to get multiple attacks off. I realize I made the mistake and didn't put the jester back in his right spot. Ooh, accusation could kill two of them.
Be gone, fiend.
Fully nullifying the chance of incoming attacks, and not really much need for heal. Yeah, we might as well attack him to try to stop him from doing an action at all. Didn't quite work out. Not the grave nibble. Oh. He's been stunned by the fact that he was actually attacked by a maggot. Oh, well. Good job.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
You about to fill my inventory? Oh. There was apparently no loot. That's unusual. I'm not really used to ending fights with nothing. What do we got here?
Packs laden with
tiny
loot
stack of gold.
Often low on supplies.
We've got two full stacks now. That's something to worry about. I might rest soon just to deal with the fact that my inventory is filling up so fast. It's not great. I can probably get away with it. It'd be a nice opportunity to get ahead of the stress game, too.
Huddled together, furtive and vulnerable.
Oh yeah, that'll burn through 10 stress for the whole party. What kind of benefits do we want here? You could also turn back party stress. Make one person gain stress while everyone else loses stress. This is a full party one, though. Every rose has its thorn. That's always nice. Accuracy and crit. This is the full party prot and stress skill. Dodge and crit. Prot and damage on self. No one needs a heal. Prevents nighttime ambush, absolutely. Always. I hate you, ambush. Let's see. Self and all companions reduce stress by 15. Yeah. There we go. Forget not that our errand is totally unjust. Alright, everyone's nice and empty on stress. We're not gonna be attacked right now.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
Not a ton in the way of buffs, but honestly, I'm more or less happy with what should be the performance of this party, so long as they don't get a surprise attack from a collector again, because I've been getting more of those than I would normally expect, I think. Let's go. We're gonna go explore this little branch here, because we don't know what's down here, and it could easily contain my objective. Definitely don't want to go missing my objective by walking past it and having to backtrack. Oh, there's a curio over there. There's multiple curios along the way. A lot of graves. Oh. You going klepto on me? Nope, it's already been looted. No opportunity for you. Alright, show us my fight. Hey! It's the thing we want, and no actual fight, which is a bit of a surprise. Alright. Suddenly we have 4 empty slots. That's nice. That is nice. So just one more infected corpse, so we're free to go. But at which point, if we're safe, I'll of course try to find as much loot as I can by continually exploring. Why'd you gotta play with a corpse? Ah, yeah, grave digging is not the cleanest of professions. Something that was not really necessary to say out loud. But the game likes to remind you. It likes to infer how stupid you were, you stupid, stupid Vestal. Alright, so this path will be clear too, with one chest or something near the end, or some curio. Oh, hungry again. We can do that one more time and then I might be in trouble, so I might have overindulged a little bit at the last time we had a chance to eat. I probably could have gotten away with, because of the zealous speech and the every rose has its thorn, I probably could have gotten away with less actual usage of the stress recovery food. Hello, trap. Trap disarm, yeah, the highest chance should definitely be the jester. There you go. A little bit of stress recovery for the jester as well. We're lower on torches than I would expect. I guess the backtracking and the non-linear pathing is having an effect on that. Hey guys, no! Regular old human crew here, huh? Well, not much stress is going on here, so let's go spread the damage around. You deserve that. You know you deserve that. Alright, this guy can target the entire party. And his stun resistance is not phenomenal. But I can't target the back row. Probably just makes sense to get a hit in there, honestly. Yeah. She's the only one that can attack the back row, though, so that might be a bit redundant to attack that one. So we'll go for the middle guy. Yeah, because the, most of the party can attack the middle guy, so we'll burn him down quick. Speaking of which, all right, is he dying a bleed? He's short by one. Frustrating, but that makes this his last turn. Ow! Okay, that actually really made sure it was last turn. Wow, that's some scary damage very quickly. Let's take some chunks out of that real quick if I can, with anyone available. Not really planning on losing my Crusader today if I can avoid it. I'll defend him now with my retribution. Helping us redirect damage a bit. You made a mistake. Alright. Let's carve some holes in this guy. Ooh. Good old crit. And now 7 damage per round. Ooh, good old crit. Greater the glory. No longer 7 damage per round. I would love to kill that guy, and I probably could, but let's try to fix this guy up a bit. Ooh, good old crit. It's a crit-heavy fight. Hey now, cut it out. Well, I guess that fight kind of finished itself. Hey, more food.
Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
Now I can go hungry 2 more times. Careful. There we go. Alright, so right now we're all set to leave this fight, this dungeon with less stress than we came in with. Which is a good situation to be in. It means that we're not really spending much money on this run besides the food costs and stuff like that. Hey now, cut it out. Alright, we're gonna have to spread the damage about. Rude. This asks for a party heal at this point. Hey now. Really wish I had retribution active already. Alright, here we go. Oh, well. Foot firmly in mouth. And despite being skeletons and everything, they don't count as being unholy. So no bonus smite damage, but apparently that's not necessary anyway. He's a scary front row fighter. Alright. Heal better, everyone. That's a strong heal, wow. I'm not afraid of using a healing item that gives her bonus stress, because on top of the bonus stress, we have a character who can deal with stress. Wow, look at that crit. Is that from the rabies? I'm actually happy he has rabies. The problem with rabies isn't the rabies itself, it's the fact that you kind of want to keep it because it's kind of beneficial, but then when you upgrade your sanitarium to remove additional diseases, there's a decent chance of removing other diseases. So right now I just want to avoid him getting other diseases if I can, because that bonus damage is actually often nice to have. Keep the party healthy. There we go. They're still green to spread around. Hola. Not a lot of stress to recover here, but not a lot else to do either way. There we go. Everyone's doing good. It's a good thing rabies in this game isn't as deadly as it is in real life. Damn. I mean, not deadly for me. It's obviously deadly for my opponents. Can't I use a shovel on a coffin?
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow
cannot.
And insidious killer.
Oh, it's slightly ajar. I'm an idiot. Sorry. I shouldn't play with coffins though, right? Right. I'm gonna play with a coffin. Ooh, insight into the nature of the world. Wheeled adventurer. That's nice. But I lost natural eye, which is probably good too. Hey, curio. That could be it. There's not much in the hallway to worry about, so I know I'm clear. Oh, he's stealing it. Who's a little bastard? Yes, you are. Alright, we got a nasty ghoul in the background. We're gonna want to heal up our man-at-arms as much as we can, because he took some damage over time back there. Ooh! The damage is spreading. Okay. Retribution. A zealous accusation will probably take out both maggots, letting us focus exclusively on the ghoul. Because I don't want them doing that, because they can stun my individual characters. There we go. Blast. A lot of damage coming in at my man-at-arms right now that I don't want to continue, so let's try to heal that. That's a start. Alright. Well, thankfully, you're in range of the big guy now, so maybe I'll just do that. Unless I want to do Zealous Accusation. Could be worth it to take out the maggot real quick while also damaging the ghoul. Yeah.
Another abomination.
Just one less problem to deal with each turn. Now it's just one enemy turn per turn. And nothing in addition. Riposte is currently active. Keep it active. There we go. Good old bonus smite damage. Was less than impressive in this particular case. Please stop dying, party. You're like my favorite thing to keep alive many times. You're just so much more useful with a pulse. Alright, 4 damage per round. Not gonna be a lot left of this guy pretty soon here. In fact, if I hit him again, he'll be down to 8 damage per round. If I do 6 damage, then he'll die of the bleed. Oh, I can't do 6 damage unless I crit, but there's a decent crit chance. There's that crit. Yep. 8 damage per round. This fight's already over. Alright. Gotta spread the health a little bit. Because 2 people are hurt.
Slowly, gently. This is how a life is taken.
You're gonna taunt me with deeds I can't carry? That's what you're gonna do to me right now? Are you for reals, man? Oh, we have holy water. Whatever. We picked up more holy water, apparently. Give me a scare for a second there, making me think I've actually dropped something that'll affect my long term. Oh, this is just a camp. Alright. So, objective not found yet. It's gonna probably be in the last corner I check. At the very least, we can work on these guys. So, retribution. Just want everyone to beat this guy down before he gets his confusion spores on. Come on, stun. There we go. First turn taken care of. Just see what we can do before it gets too far. Just at the very least, I want to have him really weak so that he gets taken out quickly after he does confusion spores, so that it's down to just being him. Because if he does confusion score and... I mean, really, it's not even just the confusion spores. Tree branch is pretty bad, too. He can do massive critical damage during one attack and really cause some problems for me. There we go, good old melee attack now that the riposte is set up. We're just gonna spam him with damage from every source to see if we can get him down in time. 19. Nope, his turn's happening. Really, he went before the jester. That's exactly what I don't want him to do. Surprised he went before the jester, given the fact that it's a jester, but hey, team immediately rearranged, so I guess it wasn't that bad. All they really did was move the jester forward, too. They're getting a lot of actions here, it seems. Alright, here we go. Alright, there goes the big bad guy.
Perhaps the turning point.
One less issue to deal with for a bit. Not a lot of stress going on, so let's just apply a bleed. You know what you did, you deserve that. Alright. Back to healing the party. Now that everyone's damaged again. And we have a corpse problem to deal with. Alright. Lucky crit. Cool, it's gone. Now we get to ruin our little crone. A fetid sensor. The word I always forget, because it keeps showing up in games. The sensor, and I keep forgetting what to call it. I'm always like, it's the holy smoke thingy. Holy smokes! You felt that, huh? I bet you did. Oh, I guess that would have kind of killed you regardless, huh? Oh, well. It happens. Single target's probably the way to go now. That feels good. Alright, he's all fixed up. Yeah, we're still pretty much set to end this mission in a better condition than we started it in. Stress was closer to 30 to 40% for each party member when we started. And it's significantly lower now, and has not risen back up. And this character is very much going to bleed to death the moment his turn starts. But maybe it won't start. Bye. 6 crests.
Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Well, that's agonizing. Are there going to be more chests? Probably. 500 gold. I don't want to lose any of my currencies that are important. I wouldn't trust myself to drop food because we could get a. It would just be a little stress though, huh? If we get hungry. Some health lost and stress. If it happens after a bad fight, though, we could be in trouble. And we have a barrier to worry about, so we definitely don't want to get rid of my shovels. Keys could still give me riches. Oh yeah, torches. We're running out anyway.
As
there we go.
Light gains purchase, spirits are lifted.
Dare we play with it?
Purpose is made
Dare
clear.
We play with it? Dare we play with it? Hey, a map. The map didn't do anything. The map of the area you've already explored was inside this tent. Sweet. I guess we can use it as toilet paper. Good find, everybody. Anonymous toilet paper, my favorite. Alright, onwards and outwards. I really hope I haven't walked past the corpse, but I think I've gotten better at not walking past key objectives. It used to be a really big problem in the first early access version of this game, because you'd have three objectives to look for, but they didn't have unique sprites yet.
A victim to the spreading
Nowadays, I think they all have unique drawings, but when the game first came out, they didn't have unique art yet, so it would just be like a curio, like that one cabinet you'll find somewhere sometimes that's kind of locked. That can be locked. Like, that cabinet would be your key item. But there would also be normal cabinets left in the dungeon, too. And you just had to know to check that one cabinet. Okay, that's not great. Alright. Gargoyles are more annoying than dangerous often, honestly. But they have a ghoul in the middle that I want to burn down if I can. Let's give them what for. Everyone just wail on this guy. Oh, there's the bad part. Stress across the party, dick. Alright, retribution time. I'm ready for you guys now. And is his bleed resist high? It's actually not. I have like a 90% chance of applying bleed if I go for it, otherwise I can go for stress recovery. We'll start off with bleeds.
Well struck.
I can go for stress recovery when the main stress character's down. Which might be very soon. He has 4 health, 4 bleed. Okay, he's dead now. Yep, so I'll be doing stress recovery for the remaining turns to try to get us down to 0-ish while these people do attacks when they can. Oh, double stun. Look at you guys. Bet you feel so clever. Now how do you feel?
Great is the weapon that
Whoops, there goes your big defender. Alright. Feel better, stunned Vestal, or I'm here to, I don't know, watch you be stunned and stand still and stuff. Howdy, folks. I might be able to kill one of them with the accusation, which would quickly reduce the number of opponents. Or I could just hit him right now. Yeah. Why not? And down you go. Alright, well, no more stress healing happening today. Oh man, I'm in so much pain. How could you do that to me? Now sit still, dammit. Alright. Not a lot of bonus damage against Unholy that time. He's down to 1, though. There we go. That should be the last fight of the dungeon. Oh my god. Alright, that's some treasure. We don't need shovels anymore. So I get away with no shovel. So definitely prioritize gold over the jade, because the jade's not really worth that much by comparison. Keys. I might need a key, but at the same time, my inventory's already filled with riches at this point. I can put more money there. 250 gold of jade versus keys is the point. There's no more fights, so we're safe. So I'll just go ahead and eat food and then drop it. I'm mainly eating it just in case there's like a collector or something. But we shouldn't have to fight again. There he is. Yep, now I'm free to go. Let's check to see what the last curio is that's down there. It could be something handy. It's a stack of stuff. It's empty. Alright, bye. Should have gotten a decent haul there. I got at least 6 deeds from the run itself. Yep, exactly 6. So I got 12 deeds overall. That's good progress towards the overall 88 we're trying to grab all in one big grinding session, basically. Two characters just hit level 5, so they won't be usable in this setup anymore. Ego and Imperio are still about. Reduced healing skills at camp. As far as diseases go, that's one of the less awful ones. I think. But none of it's ever good news necessarily.
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
Alright, so Miller and Bogdanius were cured of the worries in Onway and vampiric spirits. Zero is finally back, so I can take my low levels back in the dungeon again. Vice and Lucas and Ego and Imperial all leveled up. And that's that. See, sort by level. Alright. Oh man, you barely... In fact, I was about to say you barely have to scroll to hit level 5. It really is one little tick of the scroll wheel to hit the first level 5 now. So I have a very large team of people ready for those high-level dungeons. I just need to get the right amount of deeds in there. And we're about there. Important progress made here. I have 48 deeds, so I can pick to upgrade either armor smithing or weapon smithing to rank 5. And I honestly don't know what the best option is, but ultimately I'm going to want both. So I'm just going to go ahead and grab armor smithing because survivability is always nice. But I'm going to want the other one. So now here we go. We're on the final march for 40 deeds to get our last rank of weapon smithing. At which point the armor smith will be fully upgraded. And all of these level 5s will actually feel like level 5s, which will be good news. Hopefully we can get another antiquarian to save up some money, because as you can see, some of these people still only have level 3 armor. And it's going to cost me a fair chunk of cash to actually afford the amount of upgrades we're looking at.